sisters. The building of aqidah, the building of iman, is the mission of the prophet and messengers. And this mission is clear from the beginning. The recommendation is clear. The way is clear. The sign is clear. And this is what Allah Azza wa Jal said in Surah An-Nisa, Ayah 131. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. For Allah belong what is in the heavens and what is in the earth. وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. And we have ordered, we have recommended, we have asked those who were given the book before you and order you about what? To protect yourself from the anger of Allah. To protect yourself, to lose the great relation with Allah. The recommendation was, ittaqullah. Be righteous people. Be the people of taqwa. So this is what Allah Azza wa Jal recommend all the people of the book. And the meaning of all the people of the book, all the nation before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the recommendation to be righteous, the recommendation to be the people of taqwa. وَإِن تَكْفُرُوا, and if you reject, فَإِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And if you refuse, to Allah belong whatever in the heavens and in the earth. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَنِيًّا حَمِيدًا. And Allah is the all rich, the all independent, the ever praised. Allah Azza wa Jal, the one who own everything. Of course, he will be the all independent, the all rich, the all praised. And this ayah give us very great and very clear meaning. This ayah starting that لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Look how the heaven and how the earth are stable, are organized. The one who build this system is the one who build the system of iman. The one who build this great heavens and this great earth is the one who recommend you, the children of Adam, about taqwa. So you know that this is two different picture, but the same goal. The picture is the one who created the heavens and the earth, and this is very great building, is the one who asks you to fear him, to ask you to be righteous towards him. He asks you to build protection to you from the anger of Allah and the protection to you from losing the love of Allah, to losing connection to Allah. All of these meaning is clear in the ayat. For this reason, this recommendation is for all nation. It is not only for the nation of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is the mission of all the prophet and messenger. And this is very clear in Surah Ash-Shu'ara. If we return to Surah Ash-Shu'ara, ayah number 105, to ayah number 110. كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين. The people of Noah deny the messengers. And their brother Nuh told them, ألا تتقون? You don't protect yourself from the anger of Allah. You don't protect yourself from losing the relation with Allah. إذ قال لهم أخوه نوح, ألا تتقون? And here is very important. When the prophet Allah told and described him, their brother Nuh, oh, he is messenger and he is their brothers, yes, and they are liar. Allah said, كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين, and said about the prophet, he is their brothers. This is the way how we should call the people. The other people are not your enemies. The other people are not, but you have to treat them as you treat your brothers. This is how the Quran said. It is not my. It is what the Quran, it is what Allah Azza wa Jal said and described all his prophet and messengers as brothers to the people who are rejecter, who are liar, to advise them, to help them to become righteous. Inni lakum rasulun amin. I am to you honest messenger. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ. So be from al-atqiya. Protect yourself from Allah and obey Allah. This is the main sentences. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ. And this message will be repeated with all the prophet and messengers. This message will be repeated with all prophet and messengers. وَمَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إن أجري إلا على ربي العالمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. He repeated again and again. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. So this is what happening with Prophet Nuh. Maybe someone said, okay, maybe this is for Prophet Nuh, but not for the all prophet and messengers. We say no. Allah said in Surah Al-Shu'ara, Ayah 123, كذبت عاد المرسلين. The people of عاد deny the messenger. إذ قال لهم أخوهم هود ألا تتقون. When their brother هود told them ألا تتقون, you don't protect yourself from Allah. إني لكم رسول أمين. I am an honest messenger. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. So protect yourself from Allah and obey him. وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين. And I don't ask you any reward. My reward is from the Lord of the world. The same ayat, the same sentences, the same preaches from every prophet and messenger. And this is give us that it is the same aqidah. It is the same thing Allah Azza wa Jal asked all his prophet and messengers to ask their people about it. From the beginning, from when this creation started, when the son, the children of Adam, when Adam start on this earth, to the day of judgment. What is the recommendation from Allah? What is the recommendation the messengers and the prophet said to their people? فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ. So protect yourself from Allah and obey Allah. And this message is for every one of us. It is Ramadan. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. There is no backbiting. There is no useless talking. There is no lying. There is no wasting of time. There is no breaking to the order of Allah Azza wa Jal. You know, this is the meaning of فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. This is the meaning of fasting. This is the meaning of fasting for all the nation and for the nation of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also Allah Azza wa Jal make every prophet and messengers repeat to his people the bounties of Allah, the graces of Allah. They gave it to them, and he asked them at the end also, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ. If we repeat this ayat also with the Prophet صالح عليه السلام, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ هُودْ صالح أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ إِنِّي لَكُمْ رَسُولٌ أَمِينَ. The same ayat repeated with نبي الله صالح. The same ayat repeated with نبي الله لوط 160 in Surah Shu'ara. The same recommendation, the same ayat, and also the same ayat with Nabiullah Shu'aib. So all this is very clear. Maybe someone said, but if we return to the history, we will not find the same recommendation as you told us and as the Quran told us. We said yes, because humans are lying. Today we live, we know many accidents happening in our life through this 50 or 60 years in politics, in wars, in religion, and the people wrote the history in wrong way. They wrote what they want. They wrote what they think is right. They wrote what they believe in. They didn't wrote the truth. But Allah Azza wa Jal told us about the truth in his book. Allah Azza wa Jal told us about what is fact. Allah Azza wa Jal don't want to deceive us. He is the owner of the heavens and the earth. For this reason, what we have in the Quran is the truthful document, the truthful book. It is the one who told us the truth about everything happening for the old nation, which is related to religion, which is related to Iman, which is to related to Aqidah. May Allah Azza wa Jal give you khair and afia. May Allah accept from all of you. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Al-Fatiha. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، يا غياث المستغيثين، يا أمان الخائفين، أغثنا أغثنا توكلنا عليك يا رب العالمين. سلمنا لرمضان، سلم رمضان لنا وتسلمه منا متقبلا. يا فاطر السماوات والأرض، يا من له ملك السماوات والأرض، يا غني يا حميد، يا غني يا حميد، إنا وقفنا ببابك فقراء، إنا وقفنا ببابك ضعفاء، إنا وقفنا ببابك جهلاء. يا رب يا رب، فبدل ذنوبنا مغفرة، وبدل جهلنا علما، وبدل غفلتنا ذكرا، وبدل بعدنا قربا. يا غني يا حميد، يا غني يا حميد، جئناك ببضاعة مزجاة، فأوفي لنا الكيل وتصدق علينا. لا إله إلا أنت، سبحانك إنا كنا ظالمين. لا إله إلا أنت، سبحانك إنا كنا غافلين. لا إله إلا أنت، سبحانك إنا كنا بعيدين. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. يا رب، لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل الظالمون من بني جنسنا. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، إنا نبرأ إليك من كل ما لا يرضيك عنا. إنا نبرأ إليك من كل ما لا يرضيك عنا في هذه الأرض، من أفعال الناس، ومن تصرفات الناس، ومن فجور الفجار. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، اجعل في قلوبنا نورا، وفي عقولنا نورا، وفي أسماعنا نورا، وعن يميننا نورا، وعن شمالنا نورا، ومن فوقنا نورا، ومن تحتنا نورا. يا نور السماوات والأرض، يا نور كل شيء وهداه، نور قلوبنا بأنوار ذكرك، نور قلوبنا بأنوار محبتك، نور قلوبنا بأنوار الصلة بك. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، إذا أردت بعبادك فتنة فنجنا غير مفتونين، واعتق رقابنا من النيران، واعتق رقاب أبنائنا، ورقاب أحبابنا، ورقاب إخواننا، بفضلك وجودك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إلى شرف النبي وأرواح المؤمنين. الفاتحة.